I've booked a month. I'm going to take this one slowly and easily, working on it with Paul, Stacey, with his extraordinary collection of amps and guitars and keyboards. I'm hoping to wrap up recording the end of January, then do the orchestral and choir session in February, and be mixing through February, early March, and have the album finished by March. That's my plan.
Is it not fucking working? Oh, is it? Great.
I know, Craig, this sounds really naff, but could you roll around the drum like the toms a little bit, just a little bit?
Yeah, man.
Come and have a listen to that and see what you think.
And you're done.
So Steve. In a couple of weeks we'll have the drum sound.
Hi Craig, sorry I'm late, mate.
Hey, sorry. Just haven't got that sort of sizzling top end, which... That just sounds a little bit more punk rock, if you like.
Yeah.
Let's do the amp as well.
Yeah, I think I need to hear it with a bit
yeah,
of...
Yeah, sure. And I've got a record... Well, I'll tell you what, let me just grab the record back before I just...
Okay.
Fucking hell. Mm.
Just like really old vintage snare drums and stuff.
Tank is a 28-inch Slingerland Radio King. Wow. Some amazing, amazing vintage stuff.
Well, I have got lots of mics up at the moment. You've got lots of options, but I think it sounds pretty good.
It sounds good.
Yep. I don't know if it's right yet, but we'll see.
Let's find out.
I might actually, when you're doing the I might actually try playing eighths on the bass as well, rather than just going just a it might sound like a load of wank, but
yeah, okay,
I might try it anyway.
It's coming together, I think that'd be great.
Yeah, no, the sound's getting better as well, which is good.
How's the snare?
Snare sounds good.
Great, amazing.
Yeah.
I think we'll just do a load of interviews. I was thinking of all the tracks now of what we can use, like the 400th of Pariah.
But a track like this, I don't want to have to add too much.
That's quite tight, isn't it?
Yeah, right. So the sound is so critical.
Yeah.
It's just kind of stopping me, just won't stop, you know. It's got every little detail. Every little detail.
Click might be nice, Paul. I mean, actually, it's not so important.
be better if I had the click.
Alright.
Just for the not so much for when the drum machine comes in, but a bit before that already. Just in the background. None of that shit. No, but you know, but just just like break up the patterns a bit more.
Okay, mate. Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, no.
After you've done it, I might say no, go back and do it the way you were. But yeah. It'd be nice to try it. Both guitar players, both very good guitar players.
Yes.
Daniel Steinhardt, who runs Gig Rig, and Nigel Spennywin is a very good old friend of both of us. I used to be in a band with Nigel 30 years ago. Christ, I feel old now.
I used to work in the same guitar shop as him.
Right. And they've both been saying to me for at least the last 3 or 4 years, you should work with Paul. And I kind of, first few years, I just sort of said yeah whatever, and then this time around I went out for dinner with Nigel and he said to me again, you should really work with Paul. And I said, suddenly thought to myself, actually, you know what, this album be great to have someone that can be like, you know, co-produce it with me. And he said he'll push you, and that was it for me. So the moment he said to me he will push you,
yeah,
I thought that's what I need.
Over the edge.
Well, you know, just someone that's just not going to let me do all the same old shit I do every time, you know, and which, not that there's anything wrong with that, but I just wanted something, I wanted somebody that would push me and think about music in a different way. And so that was it. When he said that to me, I said, I should meet this guy. And then...
And that really is what a producer is, really. It's somebody that you... Well, you have to get the trust together first. You know?
But honestly, I always thought I was unproducible. I always said to everyone, I'm unproducible.
Yes.
Because when Alan Parsons came on board to do an album for me a couple of albums ago, he said to me, you don't want me to produce you? And I said, no, I'm unproducible. And I really thought I was unproducible. But actually, I think it's all a question, like you say, if you trust that person and you respect their opinions.
And we did have discussions. I mean, that's the thing, beforehand, because obviously there wouldn't have been any point in doing it if you know, I wasn't going to be...
Well, there would have been. I mean, you'd still have done a great job recording everything.
Yes,
but,
yeah.
But, you know,
but, yeah, yeah.
It's
but,
nice that it was more than that.
Yeah, no, that's right. But, I mean, the thing is you can see if it's going to go a certain way and it's just like, oh, this is going to go wrong quickly, yeah. You know. But we sort of figured that out all beforehand. I must admit, you're not producible at all. It's just that, but what you've got is that you're very sure of what you like, which is actually a relief, because when somebody doesn't know what they want and you go around in circles and you still don't know what they want and they still don't know what they want, then you just don't want to do it, you know. I think
I have a certain sort of set of parameters. I know that everything has to be within this certain set of parameters, but within that there are lots of different ways to do it.
Yes.
And I think you kind of were able to sort of show me some of the other ways we could do that, you know, recording sure. guitars or, you know, using the Celine and all this stuff. And
yeah.
and it was all stuff I kind of, instinctively liked anyway.
Yes.
But not necessarily things I'd actually done myself in my own music before.
Right.
And I think that was the difference for me, yeah.
The way I've done the stems, Craig, is... The guy drums are doing all the hi-hat stuff through the electronic sections as well.
Yeah, yeah.
But I want to take them out of the middle section and have you take over.
Oh, right, okay.
You'll still hear the 909 kick and the 808 snare stuff. Not the 808 snare, whatever it is.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But you won't hear any cymbal work there. So that's all going to be you.
Oh, right,
so
mate.
we just got to fix that.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
Doing
flat.
Yeah. So you have to, yeah, okay. You're not to F sharp.
No, just
sorry.
C.
So that's E flat.
Oh, do you mean, are you talking about in the progression?
Yeah. Sorry, I'll. That sounded good, Craig. I'm just working on something with Nick just for 2 seconds as well.
Are you talking about the actual middle section?
The very end
section.
Very end. So you're
just
going.
Two note
what are
pedals.
The two notes? It's E.
It's just C and E.
Oh, C and E. Okay.
E flat rather.
Okay. Yes. So when you go up to the E flat, so you're going da 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 da. Da 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 da. Off. Can you do that every time?
Yeah.
Just to see what that does.
Yeah.
Yeah, we just keep lying and say it sounds great. All right, here we go, mate. It sounds fantastic.
Yeah.
Here we go. God, I'm not posting any of this shit. God, me being a twat.
That he only did the tom fill once,
yes.
And quite late on in the song, where I might even have faded out. That was really good.
We got that one, Paul. So you remember what your cunning plan is for later then?
I haven't done co-production much. That I was working with Stephen as a solo artist, and he has his troupe, if you like, of people, which, you know, which we changed up a bit in places as well. We tried different things and different people, but. I suppose again it's everyone's different for me, because what you try and do as a producer is you come in at what you think's missing or what you think could be improved, and you know sometimes you're working on the psychological aspect more than anything and hardly on the music, and sometimes you're working on the sound, or sometimes you work, you know, it's like a bit like a film director, really, is that you're kind of overseeing the whole thing, you know. I mean, you as
you're
well,
making we, a record.
And you're, yeah, you're making,
making a record.
And you're making a record, you know, and you're, yeah. You've overseen everything that you've done. So joining with you and doing it without not, I don't really know so much about Steve beforehand, so.
Yeah.
So that was different, you know, but
I think that's because one of the first things you asked me is, what do you want me to do? And I said, I want you to make a record with me.
Yes.
And I think what you were asking me is, am I a producer, am I an engineer? And I'm like, I don't know, I want you to make a record with me, and whatever it takes. And I think after a couple of weeks I came to you and I said, look, obviously you are co-producing, and I wasn't sure until then how it was going to pan out, but...
Sure.
But it was just like, whatever it takes to make the best record.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
And like you say, sometimes it's to do with psychology, sometimes it's to do with Sonic, sometimes it's to do with playing, and it's whatever it takes, you know, to make the record. Mm-hmm.
doing. Yes.
The ending was really good. That time.
Yeah.
Yeah, that ending was great, actually, Jeremy. Listen, do you want to come in for a second? Is that all right?
Absolutely.
Or did you want to just bang another one?
Or use one of the endings we've already got, because we've got some great ones. Okay, well, let's do another one, yeah.
Okay.
See just, if we can top it. But I think now you've got this innate, we're pretty...
Yeah.
We're probably pretty covered.
Just on a side note, Paul.
Yes.
The bass take was superb that time.
Yes.
I just want to tell you that the bass take...
Apparently the bass take was superb on that one.
I just wanted to mention how superb the bass was on that take.
It was.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, good. There we go.
I forgot to tell you that Jeremy had asked for you to be removed from his cans.
Okay. Well, he'll be sorry because he's missed that.
He's missed out. Yeah,
yeah, he's really missed out.
Here we go.
Honestly, I can still hear him.
Okay.
Here we go.
6 feet on the ground, we move backwards now at the speed of sound. We are nowhere now. Too much time to kill, too much wasted, too much everything. There's no need to.
First thing about Nowhere Now is, you know, 6 feet underground, mm-hmm. we move backwards now. It's this idea that the human race is kind of in this state of devolution. You know, we're going backwards, looking down from here. The earth is, you know, it's a beautiful thing. It's luminous, observed, and I'm away from all the crowds, and I'm above the clouds. And so it's this idea again that the verse is this fairly gloomy, you know, look at the way we you know, we are, look at the human race in the 21st century. In the same asylum as before, the whole idea of the title is, you know, it doesn't matter what kind of religion you look at, you're still stuck in the same madhouse. So again, it's this idea of religion being a very negative human trait, a very negative human impulse. And again, that taps then into the terrorist thing and the religion theme in songs like Detonation. So there are definitely strong I think themes, albeit that they are a bit more vague and they're a bit more universal and a bit more loose. That is very new for me. I don't know why. Maybe I just got fed up with being described as the most miserable bastard in the music industry.
Yeah, I think...
I was quite proud of that.
Perfect, keep that. So I can key in for that.
Okay. It's a good start, I think. It's just
yeah.
I think it was just, good. It's just like slightly unbox it a little bit more.
So when we first drop into that groove, I just want to feel a little bit more skippy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
A little bit
more
no problem. Kinetic, you know?
Yeah. I think the snare should be the more I hear this, the more I'm thinking brighter, everything punchier, brighter.
Maybe.
To be honest, because it doesn't really, it's hard to really make this connect with it if it's sounding, I mean, it's not that there's, I like the sound, but I just think it's...
Yeah, as soon as it was like it became, as I said, was just, it sounds slight, and I know what you mean, it's on this one.
But I mean,
there's no way you're going to be able to play it.
soft.
Well, it's like even lighter. but I don't think it's. I think I mean it's like as soon as I hear the demo drums, I go, it's much more attack and bright and.
Okay.
Do you know what I mean? And that sort of.
This feels a little bit roomy and distant to me.
Yeah, it does. Yeah. That's what I think. It needs me a little bit, to be honest. But.
So, let's change it up then.
Definitely, that's great. That was a really good one.
That was a great one.
So
yeah.
You kicked the DI off.
Did I?
So that's why the bass suddenly went away. Quiet, but just in the end, just went quiet. Okay.
Yeah.
Thought
it would be quiet.
Some good one, Jeremy. Yeah.
Even though it wasn't perfect, I think I did some things in there.
Yeah.
That will cover the other.
Yeah, cover the other bit.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's great. We got.
Yeah.
It'll be a killer. Yeah, that would be a killer thing.
We got a killer track.
Nice one, man. Let's play the whole thing just quickly one more time for me. Yeah, that's good. Okay, I'm happy with that. I'm gonna go with that.
Yeah, let's do it. Fuck it. Pop music.
Fuck it, let's do it.
You ready, Rob? Should we do one?
Yeah. We don't fucking
call. Don't sound so enthusiastic. Fucking hell.
So you just play the E into that,
yeah.
And then just let it ring, but don't play until the track comes right back down to the verse again.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah.
Right. So it's just guitar.
I know that sounds like a weird thing to do, but that's kind of how I want it. I want that so it can really be weightless, and then yeah. Otherwise, it sounded great. We did.
Thank you. I gotcha.
Da 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 da.
Ninet says that sounds amazing.
Yeah.
Okay.
So there you go.
All right.
So good.
It sounds so beautiful. So let me get Ninet in there now, and then we'll see if we can get them both to work together.
Han, you need the lyrics too, right?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I've got another music stand downstairs.
Should I bring your number?
Can you bring that book?
Yeah. Of course.
I think I've got another music stand, amazingly enough. Shall I get it?
That would be great.
Okay.
So you use...
Ah, it's exciting!
Use that one, hand.
Okay.
And then I'll use my... I'll read my terrible handwriting.
You're thinking about it now a little bit.
Maybe.
So.
Or maybe you got it earlier, but would you want to try one more?
Yeah, no, I want to get it because it's like really close. Are you lighter than you would normally be, do you think?
What do you mean?
Like, are you hitting it? I almost want you to come in just a little harder.
Oh, I'm lighter, yeah, because I hear my vocal a bit.
Too loud.
Yeah.
Yes, that's what I was starting to think, is maybe now you're too loud, so
yeah.
I kind of want you to sort of like, because
on
the demo it sounds just like you're going, ah! You're just like, you know, just going for it completely, and this is more considered, which I'd like to hear one without you being considered.
Okay.
If you like.
So you need to
turn your volume down a bit.
Yeah.
Turn your volume down a bit, okay. And Stephen, great. I think, again, just squeeze anything. Squeeze something.
Okay.
Emotionally,
yeah,
you know,
because
it was all there when you're not thinking about it.
Okay. And all the worn-out things that I ever said, now it's much too late. Words stay in my head.
Yes.
So the day will begin again. Take comfort from me. It's up to you now. You're still here and you're digging again. That's comfort to you. It's up to you now. So pariah, you'll begin again. Take comfort from me. And now I'll take comfort from you.
Come in.
All
Okay.
Just to see how you feel where it's gone, but
yeah. Well, hopefully you got it now, right?
I've definitely got it. Fucking amazing.
Yeah.
Both of you.
Well, if you think you got it, I think you might have to comp a bit, me. That's all for pitching stuff.
Unless maybe a little bit, but not as much as you might think. As right. One, as soon as you stop thinking about it, the pitching was not even a question to me anymore.
Nothing left for us. Nothing is left but the blank tapes in your car.
That's really good, Stephen.
It's not the sort of, not the sort of thing you want to sing too many times because it's
it's
supposed to sound a bit broken. My performance is nowhere near as good as my demo, I don't think.
That's some good stuff.
Was it?
Yeah.
I spent a long time on the demo. It's just getting the right, the emotion just.
Yeah, no, I don't
feel right.
All I know is you'll be gone.
Just come to the door and then sort of go.
What was the previous one you had?
That was the high watt.
And what's this one now?
This is the Kelly, which is my new favourite amp.
No, that'll be the thing, is they're all got a colour. This kind of sounds like what we want right at the start of the album, just to go.
Yeah. So we just try that and.
Let's try it your way.
You understand what I'm trying to do, and then I'm happy to go. You know, if we get a sound that we like, and I'll just say, all right, change telly. Let's go have another telly here. Yeah. I'll give you this one. Now double the part this side, so it's got a slightly different timbre, you know, and then it can sound really good.
Okay. Yeah. Well, let's do it your way, and then.
Then you can tell me to fuck off. And
then I'll take the fuck off. If it doesn't sound right to me, then I'll tell you. Obviously. You know.
Sure. Very much a comfortable feeling about what you're playing. If you're used to it. So like if it doesn't sound bad, I'm not gonna get that anal about it.
Okay.
Whip
it out. Then. Jeremy's little fill in the middle of that
verse.
That's
great.
That's
great.
Yeah. That's really good.
Sorry.
I have to fucking just commit to it. It doesn't sound good. We won't use it. Oh, hello.
Proper. Oh, yeah.
Proper.
It's only proper in here, mate. That fucking. Girl shit.
Put it straight in if it works.
Shot, and then maybe I think we should call it if that's all right.
Okay.
Is that okay? Just because I'm sort of
fading.
Fading.
I think you're definitely you're in the right area.
Yeah.
It's the right sort of balance between
being able to play and not being able to play.
Well, you know, it's not that. It's just avoiding trying to play something bluesy, but without it sounding cliche.
Cliche. No, totally. Yeah.
Corny. You know, and you're in that area now. We'll be right back.
sometimes I'm going to go cliched a little bit and then I'll be going, oh well, never mind.
The first 2/3 of that was great. Just, can we have a listen to that?
Yeah, sure.
Just,
The point is, absolutely for sure, is that it sounds better to me. I mean, it doesn't matter what anybody else thinks. I think it's the analog gear is designed, and a lot of it's older stuff. It was designed by people who were really cared about sound. It really didn't have much to do with making money back then. I mean, Neumann microphones weren't about making money. They were about, let's get something that sounds as real as we can, you know. So they're works of art. Those microphones, those old microphones, the older stuff, was, you know, four or five people getting together and trying to work out how to get a better sound up from a tape machine, how to get a better sound from this. Okay, so we didn't use a tape machine, but I've been, you know, using. I spent a lot of money. You know, obviously having a real desk is for me far superior than having, you know, 20 mic pre's and then trying to figure out which one. Let's say that's just for me. So I think this stuff it's a very good thing to use on the way in, because what you record has to work. To me, it has to work. You put the faders up and it's supposed to work. It's supposed to sound like, start to sound close to the record, you know. Otherwise, you know, the sort of fix it in the mix mentality. It's probably what I used to do when I started, you know. I'm sure I can find a way around it, you know. Even though you've got your own way.
Well, I know it's really difficult for you to admit sometimes, Paul, that actually my way might be the right way.
Yeah.
But
I appreciate
for once that you've managed to swallow your pride and admit that I was right just this once.
Actually, so far, this is the only time you've been right on the album.
Yeah.
And it's day 16.
Probably not far off from being right. So I was due wasn't I?
You were due to get something right.
Yeah. Okay.
It might happen again, right?
No. Well, based on previous experience, no.
So you must make it from the. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, I was wondering. Okay.
Yes. It's a character piece, but you know, as we said, if there was a problem, we'd have to quickly scramble, wouldn't we? If you felt
it's up to you. I'm happy with
it.
I'm
sorry,
happy piano. With anything. I mean, it's pop piano.
I've used it for 10 years, and I've had nothing but, you know, sort of like occasionally somebody goes, I don't know why I'm playing this, but most people like it. So if you like it, you like it.
I think it'll be fine.
Cool.
Yeah. I mean, he's the man. If he feels like he needs to have more of a grand piano sound, that's going to be different. That's up to you.
For this stuff, I don't think so. The only one that I have a question mark over is Song of Unborn, because it's more of a symphonic sound. But for the rest, because it's like more of a pop record,
right.
Think this is going to be better than the grand piano
sound. Yeah, it'll cut through, but yeah.
The
action is very light on here. You barely have to play.
So you've been camped out here then for weeks already, huh?
Yeah.
How's it going?
Fantastic. Fantastic.
Well, it's all right, isn't it?
For me, it's fantastic.
It's been a bit hectic.
That sounds great. We've done drums, bass, just started. Ninet was here for a couple of days last week. Just started on guitars.
Yeah, so the guitars that were on the
mostly demos.
Really, those are just like is there some nice stuff on there?
There is some that are going to be kicked.
We're going to keep. Basically, now what we're going to do is just keep anything that we love on the demo.
Yeah.
We're just fighting over that at the moment, and then we're just replacing stuff.
This section, I think the piano should be more open and sustaining there.
Oh, okay, because maybe that's because there's no. I thought you wanted it real choppy. There was no foot pedal information on the MIDI file. And I was hearing this choppy thing. I thought, oh man, that must be the pop music vibe.
It's more like Elton John time, you know. But we can get that with
the
same.
Okay, so yeah, because I actually worked to make it more staccato. My natural instinct was to be. I thought it was like, oh shit, he wants to
do all that stuff.
I thought you wanted
Staccato.
It was actually difficult to do that, so this is easy.
Yeah, nice and open. Nice and open, yeah.
The best yet, we reckon.
Yeah.
Chord, but we'll get it from another take. It's cool.
Sorry.
know what? Feel it. Feel it. It almost wants to be like a little kind of a side. Not like a big blocky down. More like a... Magic. Again?
You're not saying anything, are you, Adam?
No.
Cool, here we go.
Waiting for the magic. Slow, you know you're going to off there, don't you?
Yeah,
that's
I know.
Choral.
I know, but see, I want to be able to jump from choral to here, but okay, I thought I could do it quicker if I was right here.
Do you want me to do the Leslie, Adam? Because I know exactly where I want it.
Okay, fine. Yeah.
Should we try one with me?
Put your hand over it so that it doesn't get caught.
Us as a team.
See what Paul thinks about that. Leslie, too much or?
And we'll.
Okay, I'll be more confident we find uses for the Serena.
I think the Serena's going to make more.
Yeah.
I'd love to see you again sometime.
Yeah.
It's kind of something like that. I think it's going to be a bit sort of just hit and miss and see what happens and crazy shit going on. Do you know what I mean? It's slightly middly and hollow, the sound.
Yes.
I wouldn't mind hearing something a little bit more meaty and a bit less middly as a backup to that. We might find a sound and say, you know what, that's much better. We might not, but I'd just like to spend a few minutes exploring a different sound. This is the last thing on this track. Fucked up the end, but that's a good sound now, I think.
I think the sound is fucking great.
Sounds
great.
It's
like great. Really vibey, and it's sort of, it's cool because it's not like, it's actually not like Pete Townsend or anybody.
No. Again, please. And again.
We get rid of that.
Yes, please.
Something else, which would be
like you were
in a band improvising and nobody knew the chords properly.
Yeah, that's the snap. That's great. The snap. That's great. I just came in wrong. That's all. I was too excited.
Clue where half the stuff is, so I've been trying to find stuff before this session. It just drives me insane because there's certain pedals I can't use unless I have the power supply. That is just incredibly annoying. I'm hoping there's one. Even flow, right, I'm good. That's good, right.
What does the blue pedal do?
The blue pedal.
Yeah.
It's a random looping device. It'll do.
Oh, it's a looper.
It's a looper, but it's.
Could be interesting.
It will literally. You'll have to play. You'll play one thing, and it'll do it. It'll either make something happen. These are the sort of make something happen type pedals.
Okay.
I haven't finished plugging in. There's a couple of other things I was going to try and plug in, but
there's a chance to do something quite interesting with looping and stuff at the end of Refuge, I think. Part of it too, though, you know that. Thank you.
I think that's.
So I prefer the other one.
You prefer the other one?
Yeah, I prefer the one that I did.
Oh,
well,
okay.
We need to have the option.
But you can have the option.
Now that we've got the sound pool, let's have one like that too.
Would you mind giving us that option? Because I think that I've got used to that.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, I want to hear your version of that, you know. But I like the syncopation definitely at the start.
Let's have one like that.
Yeah, let's just do
something like
that. Yeah,
so. That's fucking brilliant.
Love it.
Unfortunately, we actually like that much better. So,
Fred, whatever you like.
So you were wrong.
I don't care.
What you played was right. What you said was wrong.
Sorry,
I'm such
no,
a
I'm going to get another microphone. Now,
so what I do all the time.
Say it.
So what I do all the time.
Really?
But, yeah. No. Very, you know, like.
But in this context?
In houses, like dance music.
Oh, it has been. A bit, not in this context, though.
No.
It doesn't sound. I mean, what I'm saying is.
It doesn't sound
like a load of cliches.
No,
it?
No.
No, good. Sure. Right. It's just
a great anchor bar, a great,
yeah.
You know, kind of swung tumbao.
The original was like a loop, the logic's, it's in logic, you know?
Yeah.
Just sounds great.
Fucking conquered that fucking bit.
Yeah, really good. Awesome, man.
That's having it.
Love it.
Yeah, that's great.
We're done on that one.
Well, the congas are quite dark, you need the tap rig really to fit light.
Yeah, all that information in it.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, fuck me, it's like an Aladdin's cave in here, isn't it?
Well, it is like
it's
an Aladdin's cave.
It's fucking brilliant.
Yeah.
You have to go to the BBC to get as much shit as this.
I don't think there's another studio, and I'd be surprised if another studio in the world that has this stuff.
No, it's unbelievable.
That has all this stuff, you know.
It's got the old Baker Street desk for a start.
I know. It's like you say to Paul, yeah, have you got like an old like 1960s tape Echoplex? Yeah, I got four of them.
Yeah, it's not one.
No. So I got four of them. They all sound different.
Yeah, I know.
It's unbelievable, really. Yeah, we've had a lot of fun, actually.
Yeah,
I've really enjoyed it. It's always been fun every day, pretty much.
Yeah, well, you know, when you've got a good vibe, it will come across.
Exactly. Actually, you know, we were kind of joking about you rummaging through your percussion box.
Yeah.
I almost want it to have that vibe. I don't want it to sound like...
I'm marking sections.
Yeah, I almost want it to feel like there is this kind of random chaotic element to it. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, like you're dropping things and picking things up and... Yeah, I almost want that kind of vibe. Do you know what I mean? I'd love to see
sometimes. Will you give back to work, isn't it?
Yeah, just
a little bit
sort of lower in the mix, just nice eerie kind of textures. Yeah. Right, let's do this.
Let's do stupid fucking shaker shit.
Full stupid idea.
Yeah.
Be able to get this. I'm not sure if we might have to extend this lead. Yeah, that's better. I've lost one ear now. Unless I'm going deaf in that right one. Paul, let's just run with it. Go on, go from the front and let's see what we can. Can I have these lights down in here? That's it. I just want to vibe up.
Right.
Just want to vibe up, yeah.
Yeah.
Good man. What, you want me to play now? Okay, buddy, let's go. Mmm.
And I like the way you kind of fell into the on the verse, the doubling the da 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 da.
Yeah, I wasn't sure the first time.
But that was good. Because it didn't sound planned. It sounded more like you just kind of responded, and that was really nice.
Okay.
But we'll do another one where you've maybe
tighten those up.
You know it a bit better. Exactly, but I mean, yeah. I may end up preferring that one anyway.
Okay.
Yeah, sounds great.
It's just one mic, is it, Paul?
It's just a 67, it's amazing. The old bug standard.
That's fantastic. That's how I hear.
Oh, good.
A kind of mixed vibe. You know, I'm not the best at the technology side of things. I'm sorry. I was just saying, Steve. I think that's a tape. I really do. I love that front.
I love it.
Oh yeah.
Take kind of guy, aren't you?
Yeah.
Wow. The magic from first takes. Job done, mate.
Job done. Yeah.
Well done.
Nice.
Well done.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Cheers,
Mark. I'll tell you what,
you
smell better than me.
Yeah, there you go, bro.
You're
fresh.
Dress
is better than you. Fuck's sake.
Oh, that was all right, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah. That was a pleasure.
Yeah.
That was a pleasure to listen to you play, mate. 75 quid to find a pop shield.
I mean, I'm old fashioned, so you know, I like older records, and I think older records carry on selling. I think they always seem to be like people are always doing re-releases of, you know, the old classics. And so, is anything that's happened in the last 10 years going to be a classic? Maybe, yeah, there'll probably be one or two things, but not like it's not the volume that it was back then. But that's because music has kind of petered out, and like everything, because of computers, everybody's got, you know, everybody can do music.
There's two things for me. Firstly, the definition of someone as an artist is you do it for yourself, you don't do it for other people. So firstly, that's a good enough reason alone to want to make it sound good. It's because an artist basically paints, writes songs, makes music for themselves. Artist is not necessarily an entertainer. The second thing is that there are actually a lot of people out there now. There's a growing audiophile community that love
great
things
sounds.
That sound great.
Yeah.
You've got Pure Audio Blu-ray, 9624 resolution. You've got now you can download full resolution files from services like Deezer. I'm not sure about Spotify now, but certainly you can download 9624. And there are people, surround sound. There are people out there that care about that, and they are a minority. They are a substantial minority, and they're growing.
trouble is it's all pricey shit. Like if I was picturing it, it's almost like it's late at night and you don't want to wake anybody up, but you, do you know what I mean?
Great God, I don't believe in you.
Just
great
like, yeah.
God, I don't believe in you. There you go.
Do you see, that's it. Yeah, here we go. Should we just go in 2 seconds before?
Great God, I don't believe in you, but still I will do what you want me to. Stand up and fight in the city streets. As much I know, you expect of me.
Yeah, that was good. Just do what? Just do.
Yes.
Do one more for me.
Yeah.
This time, just go in a little bit on the microphone and sing a little quieter, but get with the same, with your cheeks up or whatever you're doing, okay?
Great God, I don't believe in you. Still, I will do what you want me to.
Try that one more time. I'm just giving this line. What I like about it is it's more convincing than what you've got, I think.
Yeah, oh yeah, it is, yeah.
So it's got, it doesn't, the distortion isn't covered. The distortion was making it sound like you were covering it up. If it,
which is exactly what I was doing, yeah.
Well, of course, yeah. And I mean, the thing is, but this actually doesn't, all this is, it's distorting in stages, so it's like it's helped a little bit, but it's...
Makes it more edgy without being...
Yeah, well, that was the last take.
Are you trying it? You mean...
Yes, that's good. That's good. Yeah, that's better, I think. Enunciate a little bit more, yeah.
Who are you proud of all your failures? Are you dragging Mother Nature down?
Okay, I'll try.
Yeah, that works, I think. So, here we go. Sorry, I'll stop from the beginning.
Yeah, that's really easy. You can get a fucking good sound to start with.
I think, yeah, that sounds good.
It can be jumped through hoops.
Well, recording is more about performing than anything, so let's let's here we go.
Let's do it.
Yeah, that's whatever's happened, that's it.
Thank you.
sounded very happy.
When I say I'm unproducible, I always kind of, it's always that thing where someone takes you down your sound, down a sort of road that you don't feel comfortable with, and I never felt that with you ever, you know.
Well, that's, to me, that's what I rail against, because I just don't think that that's producing. I think that's somebody doing a solo album, you know.
But that's what lots of producers do.
Yeah, they do their own solo album and then kind of manipulate you into doing something that, you know. And I say, with artists who don't know what they want, then that's the perfect combination. So it's not like it's bad, it's just that, but for me it's all about working with people who are really good at what they do, really good musicians. I don't want to work with people who can't play ever again. And luckily I haven't had to do that very much. But people who have got a vision themselves, and then what you hopefully can do is say, try this time, you know. But it's not about dominating or manipulating it at all. It's unless they're completely useless anyway, in which case then you can go and do your solo album with somebody else's budget.
But then at the same time, I don't want, and this is another reason why I was keen to change things up, I don't want to make ever the same record twice.
No.
And lots of people do. Lots of artists just keep making the same record.
Yes.
And for me, that's the opposite. I want every record to have a distinct, a reason to exist in the catalogue, you know. This is a very different record to any I've made before.
This track needs a more electronic vibe.
You know, music business and music don't have an awful lot in common, you know.
There's no, well, that's what I mean. It's
not really why. I mean, if you're a musician and you're a really good musician and really good writer, and it's obvious that you've got something that you want to say, then, you know, the advice is, you know, stay clear of that world and do it, you know, buy a computer and, you know, do it yourself, you know, or be around like-minded people and try and find the best quality people that are, you know, that are in the same league as what you think you might be, and work with them, work with the best, you know. I always say now
if you're starting now and you really want to make music, I say do it because you love it. Don't even think about having a career.
Yes.
And if you end up having a career,
it's a bonus.
By accident, great. Yeah. But that's a surefire way to destroy everything that's probably unique and special about what you do, or what you can do. And that's the problem for a lot of people, because I think they still think of music as a possible career path, and there's too much music in the world. There's already too many musicians, yeah, too much music. You're trying to get into an industry where there's already a surfeit of fodder and music. And the mistake a lot of people make is thinking they have to compromise and fall in line with all that, because it's the worst thing you can do, you know.
Yeah.
You should accentuate what's different about yourself, but that, unfortunately, that also makes it a lot harder. So I say, don't even think about it as a career. It's just, which is a hardened lesson to say to someone, that just all they want in life is to be a professional musician.